So are you all in the mood to listen about spirituality after all the fashion and all that stuff?
For sure, for sure. More than excited to.
Okay, so thank you very much for being here, and I have to thank Jyotika for getting me here, and Sarita ji, who is the organizer of the whole thing, and the whole thing is because of her. Sarita ji, thank you for being here, and thank you for having me over. So today what I'm going to tell you is something really very simple which you can implement in your life. I personally do not believe in complicating matters. When I started with spirituality, which was almost around 32 years ago, as it's been ever since I started with my film career. So, I met my first master, Prabhuji, in the first year of my film career. And thankfully, because of that, I have my feet firmly on the ground. Because you know how films, even a little bit of success, can just throw you completely off ground, which we have seen all the time. So, over the years of the film career, in my peak of my career and whatever I did, whenever any master told me, you do this or do that, my first thing is to say, I don't have the time. Which is a very common sentence which everyone says, I don't have the time. Now, we have time, as I heard all the fashion designers say, we have time to go for shopping, checking out the fabric, finding out about all that, every other thing we have time to do, which is our passion, but we have no time for ourselves. Right? So I was just sharing with Jyotika, in fact, when we were coming over here, I said actors and politicians especially must understand or anchor their life in something. I'm an actor, so I can tell you about actors. What happens is we are always doing a particular role. We are acting a particular role. Correct? We are somebody, or a doctor, or a lawyer, or some oblanari, or something like that. Correct? So you're always playing some role. There is no time to meet ourselves. There is no time because you're constantly playing. Then again, besides these masks that you keep on wearing, you make one particular idea about yourself, that I have to be like this. Again, the world outside expects certain things out of you. For example, if I have played mother's roles and a good mother all the time, as everybody has seen me how I have been all throughout, suddenly if I wear hipsters or if I wear these like jeans or very short pants or short skirts and blouse like this and I start smoking, they'll say, what the hell has happened to her? She's lost a plot somewhere. So this is the image what public makes of you. So I have to be in that framework also. So can you imagine the amount of masks we wear throughout our lives? Correct? So when do I meet myself? That happens when your career is ebbing, is when you start seeing yourself, when the self starts emerging in front of you, this is how you have been, this is what you have done, all those things. And why finally the actor hits to the bottles, because it is very difficult to face yourself. Hum duniya ko unko bana sakte, apne aap ko nahi bana sakte. So to face ourselves is the biggest challenge that we have. And that exactly is what's happening to everybody over here. After about the age of 35-40, all these stories of yours start coming up, which you call them problems in life, and you don't know how to handle them because you've never bothered to look at yourself till that time. Because till that time you're making your career, you've done very well, you've achieved your fame, name, etc., etc., with most of them. And then when you start having challenges, when you have children or around that age, whatever, you have your health problems, you could have a relationship problem, you could have children issues, you could have something or the other. These stories start coming up in your life. That is the stage when you don't know what to do with yourself. And the question is, why me? Every person who goes through a problem in life always says, why me? Maine to kisi ko bura nahi kiya. Maine kisi ko tang nahi kiya. I've been always very good. Phir bhagwan ne mere sath aisa kyun kiya? How many of you have asked this question to yourselves? Almost all. Phir bhagwan ne mere sath aisa kyun kiya? My question is, why not you? Give me one reason why you should not have a problem when the whole world is having challenges. Who are you? Danish, your sister? Mirabai's daughter? Kabirji's brother? So why not you? The question here now is, how do I deal with it? Okay, now you've come to the point. Fine. Everybody goes through challenges in life. Why not me? Right? But how to deal with it if each one is going through these problems? Now guys, when I'm telling you this, standing over here, please for a moment also don't think that ye to abhi successful hogi, ye bada gyan hai, ye humko aaye. Please don't think that I have not gone through all this. I'm standing and talking over here and telling you all this because I have all gone through all this. I have come from in a joint family. I was 20 when I got married. We were 16 of us in the house. I was the youngest. Could not speak because my parents-in-law were fairly old when they got married. My husband was born to my father-in-law when he was 52. So there's a huge age gap. So they were very, very old. And I was like a little tiny little lamb in that house. I didn't know what to do and where to go. So we've had domestic problems. I've gone through all that. Lived with mother-in-laws and sisters-in-law and all that. No servants many a times, domestic help, just to go to town. So I've done jhadu pota, I've washed vessels, I've washed clothes, all that I have done. So don't even for a moment think that I do not know what all this is, what life is. I've seen it all and I've done it all. So the question here is, how do you get over your challenges in life? Does anyone have an answer? What to do? Yeah?
I guess we are the one way is to see that other's problem is bigger than mine. Okay, mine is really problem more bad. So, you know, once you were saying that why not you? So there is one way of seeing ki chalo theek hai mera ye ya samne wale ka sir bura hai. So
maybe to aap apne ghamon se samjhota kar rahi hain. So you are putting your problem under the carpet. So how do you deal with yours?
Their best, whatever's
going to
happen.
Yeah, Siddharth, we understand that over here.
Yeah.
But when it comes to putting it into practice.
So we've been practicing with problems and never been.
Yeah, 100%. But what we do is we resign to the fact. I'm saying accepting it or surrendering to it. Humko choice hi nahi hai.
Absolutely.
Whether you sar patka on the wall or whatever, you have to only deal with your issues.
Whatever's
going to
happen is
going to
happen.
Correct.
Nothing.
Absolutely. So acceptance and resignation are two different things. So usually we resign. We don't accept or we don't surrender to the whole thing. And because we resign, because dana thot khamke, not only continue, we are doing this, is the cause of all the stress that is causing in the relationship, I mean, outside of you and inside of you. So we need to balance that out. That is where the issue is. That's what we got to deal with. The very simplest of things which all my masters have taught me, I've had three masters in my life. My present masters, Dada Shri Ji, we have a small ashram in Kajat, which is called Maitri Bodh Parivar. You can check online about it. So all my masters, the one common thing, or most masters today, spiritual masters, the most common thing what they say, and that one line that they say is, your connection with your divinity is lost. The minute you have a challenge in your life which you can't handle, which means there is some kind of a disconnection somewhere. At the moment we are in the state where we have really lost connection with the source completely. There are so many people who ask the question, where is God? So there is a doubt, hai kya Ishwar kahin? There's always this sort of a question which comes in your mind, where the hell was God when this happened to me, where the hell was God when that happened? When tsunami happened and falana happened and dimkan happened. Correct? So there's a question mark, is there God? is the divinity. So how many of you believe that there is a divine force? I don't want to use the word God, I don't like it. So most of us believe that there is divine force which is guiding us, right? How many of you have the divine force guiding you, actually feel the presence of the divine force guiding you? You feel the divine force, actually feel the divine force guiding you. So that's excellent. Now I'll tell you what I mean that the connection is lost. It can be even stronger when we come to the actual crux of the matter. You know, my master Dadashriji, he had told us once the story that people, log jo hain kabutar ki tarah hain. People are like pigeons. Main daane daalta hu, chunte hain, ur jate hain. Main daane daalta hu, chunte hain, ur jate hain. Lekin daana dene wala haath jo hai, us haath ki taraf unki nazar hi nahi jati. So this is what we are. What we do is small materialistic tokens that we get, we are happy about, but internal suffering we are unaware of. We feel that we are happy if my husband takes me for a world tour, or my children pass and they get admissions in some foreign college or something like that, or some such other thing which you're looking for. Oh, I want a job so badly, you got a fabulous job which you never even expected. So you place your happiness on something like this. Internal suffering, most of the time you are unaware of. People who are wealthy are even more unaware of, because when you have money, lot of money buys a lot of things. Jo chalta hai, apna kaam nikal jata hai, a lot of things are there. But I'm talking of the actual suffering. When you're going through that suffering, I'm not talking of pain. I'm sure you know the difference between pain and suffering, right? So to make it in one line, pain is of the body which can be cured, suffering is of the soul. Yeah, so the suffering that you go through, you are completely unaware of. Is that right? Do you agree with me? So most of the time, if there's a discord between a husband and wife, between a child and a parent, or between friends or office jobs or whatever, there's a discord, you cover it up. You cover it up and you samjhota karte hain, jaise Smita ji ne bola, you samjhota karte hain hum apne ghamon ke sath. We compromise. We do compromises and this is how we've been living. Now what I suggest or whatever I have noticed, we don't have to live like this. We don't need to live like this. We can handle every issue. Spirituality has an answer to every challenge or every problem you have. Do you agree with that? And only spirituality has an answer to that. Spirituality has a solution to every of your problems. But do not cut that connection with the source. Source is from wherever whatever you think is coming out, or whatever your definition of divinity is. That is up to you, what you consider as source. Sun could be the source for you. You could connect with the sun. Or any form of divinity which you relate to or you connect to. But we have come from the source you will never see. I'll tell you a story. So it's easier to connect to things through stories, and I love telling all these stories. एक बच्चा है छोटा जो रोज स्कूल से आने के बाद ही यूज टू प्ले इन द कंपाउंड नीचे. हिज मदर हैज टोल्ड हिम 7 बजे ही तो घर पे आना है वापस. सो द चाइल्ड कम्स अप आफ्टर प्लेइंग 7 o'clock. द चाइल्ड कम्स टुडे दिस चाइल्ड 7 o'clock हो गए, ही डिडंट कम अप. सो द मदर वेंट एंड चेक की किधर गया, ये दिखाई नहीं दे रहा है. तो सोचा मे बी ही इज एट अ फ्रेंड्स प्लेस. 8 बज गए एंड शी गॉट वरीड. सो शी वेंट डाउन, शी आस्क्ड ऑल द फ्रेंड्स वेयर द हेल इज द चाइल्ड गॉन. दे कुड नॉट फाइंड द चाइल्ड. बोथ द पेरेंट्स पैनिक्ड. अराउंड 9:30 दे वेंट टू द पुलिस स्टेशन टू फाइल अ कंप्लेंट दैट द चाइल्ड इज नॉट देयर. दे वर मिजरेबल. एवरी डे दे यूज्ड टू गो टू द पुलिस स्टेशन टू फाइंड आउट वेयर माय चाइल्ड वाज. On the other hand, the child has been kidnapped by somebody. He is growing up. Today he is about 25, 30 years old. And he's completely forgotten his parents, his biological parents, because he was quite young when he was kidnapped. Yeah? And here, the parents every day go to the police station to find out where is my child, take it. This is exactly the state of that source. We have come here, we've forgotten that we've come from the source. But the source is still waiting for you to go back there. This reminds me of that song from Border. Sande se aate hain, hame tadpate hain, ki ghar kab aoge, ki tum bin ghar suna suna sahi, is what the source is telling us. So we have somewhere lost, we are lost. And we've forgotten that source from where we've come. Us haath ko hi bhool gaye jisne humko banaya. Now what do you have to do to connect to the source? Anybody? Any ideas? Very simple ways, because I don't believe in anything complicated, removing time, especially as a dhyan karke baitho vagare. Wo meditation karo, if you like it, when you have the time, do it please. It helps. I'm not saying stop anything what you're doing or now japa or whatever you're doing. But for people who feel that I don't have the time, or sometimes when you may really not have the time, but still the connection is not lost. What is the easiest way of connecting with the source? That is an offering. That is, jab kaam ho jata hai, tab gratitude mein ki mood mein aa jata hai. What do you do to connect? Yeah.
Loving yourself.
One thing. Yes. No right answer, no wrong answer. You can just say what you want. Yeah.
I mean silence.
Silence.
Inner silence.
Right. We know all these things, but unfortunately we don't know how to get there. Agar wo silence humko mil jayega andar, we're done. We know all this. We've read so many books and we've heard so many people. We know all this here mentally, but it has to touch you somewhere here. It has to become your reality. Yes, sir, you were asking.
Meditate in the shower.
I'll tell you something better to do when you're having a shower.
Purity?
Yes, children can really get some kind of a something with children. Yes, also. Anything else? Any other way? So I'll tell you the secret. The secret to be in touch with the source is talk with the source 24/7. Anything you want. Is it difficult? You can do it either better. Now, what is the source according to you is what you have to define. Whoever you take as divine is the source. Like suppose, for example, when we were told this in the ashram when we were doing this process, I could not figure out what is the source, kaise ye saari cheeze ki jaye. So, we are great believers of Sai Baba also. So, मैंने सोचा कि चलो साई बाबा को मैं एक divine form में लेती हूँ. Because there was still, it was hazy for me that time. So I'm sure just now it must be the same condition for you. So Sai Baba को मैंने दिमाग में रखा था. Okay? So said, चलो साई बाबा could be the source. Because source actually we can't see. We see the source through a form, whether it's your master, whether it's your guru, or whether it's a divine form you believe in. Right? The actual source we'll never be able to see and touch, right? So, I had Sai Baba ko is form liya. So then they told me that take any divine form, the best relationship you have to find with the form is a friend. And why is a relationship important? Because if there is no relationship, it's a dry conversation. Abhi bhi hum mandir mein jaate hain, haath jodte hain, prasad chadhate hain, ye chadhate hain, wo chadhate hain, nikal aate hain. You're not having an emotional relationship with your divine. Which is very important. Jab friend hote to hug se bolte hai na, isn't it? Acha Deepika, please, you got to come for my program. How dare you not come? But if I don't know Deepika, I will say, well, I was told to call you up and please come for my program, isn't it? Bole ki jaan to I don't even know her. Why the hell should I go for a program? Hota hai. So it's very important to form a relationship. When there's a relationship, there's emotion. And Ishwar jo hai, wo emotion samajhta hai sirf. God only understands emotion, right? Bhav samajh mein aata hai. Right? So if there's no emotion, there is no connection. So it's very important to have a relationship with your divine. So the best relationship was told to me was to have a friend, friendly relationship. But you make divine your friend, make him a divine friend. Because friend hota hai, toh wo haq hota hai, doston ke saath. Hum sari cheeze baant sakte hain doston ke saath. When it's a parent, you are hesitant to share certain things that you do and you don't want to tell your parents. Correct? Guru, toh then he becomes a master, he will test you. So the best relationship is a friend. Because you can sulk, you can get angry, you cannot talk for some time. And it has to be done alive. That relationship has to be so jagrit. Don't keep it dull. Don't be indifferent. You may fight, you may argue, you may do what you want, but don't be indifferent to your friend. Understand? So that friend has to be there with you 24/7. You have to talk to that divine friend 24/7. इधर बैठे अगर वो बोलो तो ये भी बोलो कि भाई ये मेरे को बहुत बोर कर रही है. इसका क्या मेरे को सुनने का नहीं. Okay? So you can talk to your friend anything internally. Don't go blabbering outside. So you talk internally, but keep your divine as a friend because that is the best relationship you can have with your divine. Now this is a tried and tested formula. For me, I cannot be anywhere without my friend. I travel, I go alone all over for my shoots or whatever. They always ask me to akeli kaise jaati hai sir. Nothing. I never have felt alone. I've been guided at every moment. And that is a transformation that I'm talking of from within. I know what Kabir ka sheer is transformation. Sheer no sorry, Duha. Kabir ji kehte hain, Mala kahe hai kaat ki, kaat ki se jap mala. Mala kahe hai kaat ki, tu kyu phere mohe? To mala keh rahi hai, tu kyu phere mohe? Man ka phir le so turat mila do tohe. So the whole thing is because you are not connected inside, you are not transformed inside, is why you can't see the divinity around you. So for divinity to be in within you, with you all the time, you have to connect to your source. I'll tell you one, I've got plenty of such experiences where I can tell you how divine has helped me. It is uncanny how things have happened in my life. We were, as a family, you know, stayed at Sipnopa some years back. My boys were not very small. They were about, say, 15, 17 year old. Okay? In Australia, we, one of those two places, we went on these rapids. And I can't swim, so I'm very scared of water. So we went on these rapids. And they told us over there that you don't have to worry, life jacket is mandatory. So our kids have to life jacket pehenge. There were three boats, we were a big group of people. There were those three boats and there were four lifesavers on every boat. So we were X amount of people on each boat. Now because I am scared of falling and of water because I can't swim, they told me you sit on the floor of that boat. And the others were sitting on the side and they were rowing the oar. You know how the rapids are, the oars go on about that. Right? So I was sitting on the floor of the ship holding on to those ropes tight. Okay? Pehla rapid ho gaya, achi tarah se ho gaya, sir, fine, I'm okay. Second wala ho gaya, I was absolutely fine. The third one, now before I went on the rapids, I was feeling so scared to go. So the inner voice that came in, if you have faith, you should not have fear. If you have fear, which means you don't have faith. I said, no, faith to mera bahut zabardast hai. I said, to be chao, what is going to happen? Now that's the reason why I went on that. So third rapid, which has never happened ever according to them, but the third rapid, all our boats turned upside down. Now all these people have turned the boats turned upside down. They all know how to swim, but they came out of the boat. For me, I was on the floor, so boat puri mere sar pe upar thi. And I was under that boat with that helmet and all those gadgets and I couldn't breathe and I thought I'm dying at that moment. most people in the lifesavers didn't know, where did I disappear? Where did I go in that short time? Nobody could find me. Nobody knew I was under the boat. So I was literally praying. Okay, I said, I don't know what's going to happen, but I was absolutely going breathless. But somehow, I don't know how that happened, the boat somehow went up, and one of the lifesavers saw that boat going up. They thought, okay, there's somebody down there. But they turned the boat, they pulled me out, and all that, the other things were done. And I was hearing my children at that point in time. I said, where is my mother? She can't swim. And my God, that voice is still resounding over here. They were so scared because I couldn't swim. When I got back, it was like, I couldn't understand what the hell was happening to me. But how that boat went bobbing up when they realized that I was down, I have no idea. So I've had plenty of these life and death kind of situations. I can tell you plenty of them, how divinity has saved me. But my connection with divinity is so strong and so solid that no one can enter it. So again, what I tell you, conclusion, Jyotika is saying, time up. So the best way to connect with the divinity is talk to the divine 24/7. You can try it from now itself. How you will get help at each moment is something you will be shocked. And then of course gratitude just comes along with it. Gratitude is an emotion which you just express for things that have happened in your life. It's amazing. So this, for this you don't have to remove separate time. It can be done right now, right here, from right now, right here. Yeah? So try it out. Yeah. But to conclude, I can say, please do connect with your divine, if you have a divine form inside you. And you see the results right now, right here.